put those vice grips down and lock it down and change that culture of the way that the family court system is being ran, that opens up doors. And then all of a sudden their eyes like comes like, you know what, you are right. You know, the child needs both parents 50-50. I have a judge out of, I want to say Cynthiana, that I heard say to a case that it doesn't matter what, I'm putting 50-50 share parenting down and y'all are going to learn to get along.
There you go.
That's what he said. Y'all are going to learn to get along. And that's the way it ought to be.
That's
It ain't nothing, you know, it should be about this or that, or trying to come up with all this stuff to try to keep it from having shared parenting. Look, if you know that these are two parents that's willing to work together and take care of their child, and there's no evidence of no alcoholism and no drugs, anything like that, why fight it? Why fight it? No.
Exactly.
Sure. So,
Well, that's exactly what that counselor said to me. That's exactly what she said to me. Now, brother, I got three quick questions for you before we conclude today. Matt Hale, tell me a little bit something about brother Matt Hale. You said he's your mentor. Go ahead.
Matt Hale, I tell you, Matt Hale was a blessing to this state and all of us. Matt Hale actually started out with a temporary bill before this bill became law. And he got a couple of doors shut down on him, but he still continued to do it. Matt Hale had shared parenting from day one, but he wanted to help other families have shared parenting because he knew the importance of shared parenting. So he went to a few lawmakers, and they started to really pay attention to him. And so we got a couple of help from basically all of us to go ahead and make this into a permanent bill. But Matt Hill is the, I'm going to say the godfather of shared parenting. You have no idea how many states, big wigs has came to him. We need your help. We need your help. And he has helped to get, I want to say the other two states is Missouri and Arkansas, I believe. I may be wrong, but I know Missouri for sure. And I mean, he helped them get shared parenting. I mean, he's Ohio almost became a shared parenting state. It actually came close, but we're still continuing to fight. And my thing is, I have a 10-year-old daughter. She'll be 11 within a few weeks. And I fought very hard for her in the family court system. I know how that arena is, and there was a couple of things that really lit fire up under me to really like just seek out and trying to help others. And I tell you, this is a subject that will always be a passion of mine. I've mentored so many kids. I love being in the community. I just love our kids, because our kids is our future. And I've had great mentors. I've had great dads, you know, and I said dads, plural, that's been in my life and that's helped me become the man I am. And that's one of the reasons why that I decided to do the documentary, because I want the whole world, not just the United States, the whole world, because the whole world's going through this. Not just our country. You talk about other countries that got it worse off than what we do. And everybody knows, honestly, the reason why shared parenting isn't a talkable subject in other states. You know, you follow the lead of that money, you'll see the reason why. But we're going to still continue to push with this shared parenting, and create paths and blueprints for other states, because our kids, when I look at all this negative stuff on TV, when I sit there and I read articles and I'm just reading, and now I'm starting to see things, is where's the dads at? why don't we have more dads out here? Well, you have dads out here, and there's dads willing to be in their children's life, and it's just not dads, it's moms too, but mainly the focus on dads, because it's always been a stigma that dads doesn't pick up the slack. There's a lot of dads that pick up the slack, but you know, they get shut out for other things. And you know exactly what I'm saying with that.
Yes, sir.
But I mean, I even heard Senator Rubio mm-hmm. even mentioned about fathers and dads and the amount of money that is made off of missing fathers in their kids' life. And you know exactly what he means by that. You
yes,
know,
sir.
He's a senator. So yeah, I'm in it to win it. I got a really good team behind me. Mm-hmm. I got some powerful people behind me, and we're going to win this. We're going to win this for the good.
And you had mentioned one other person that, you know, I was assuming is sort of like part of your team, is a doctor at the University of Louisville. Was his name again, brother?
Dr. Ryan Schroeder.
Ryan Schroeder.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And you said he had read a lot of studies that basically say, hey, shared parenting's it. I mean, the evidence is overwhelming. Yeah.
All right. Yes.
All right, brother. Well, I got to conclude here. Thank you so much for coming out. I just want to say to folks, this is Book Talk with Corbin. I'm your host. Go to my website, booktalkwithcorbin.com. You'll see the first interview I've done with this brother. He's a good man. And we're going to talk about, hey, I want to encourage you, go to YouTube, do exactly what the brother said. Put in the search engine, HB528 Blueprint. Go to YouTube, youtube.com. Put an HB528 Blueprint, and that'll be the trailer. And wait, you know, that movie's going to come out. And as soon as it hits, y'all better be buying it. And don't just buy one copy. Buy two. Buy three.
Yes,
keep
sir.
Keep one. Give one or two others out to some other fathers. You all right?
Yes,
don't
sir.
Buy just one. Two, three. And give the other one, two away. And I just like to, again, thank you and conclude this interview by saying, to my daughter, Sarah, Daddy loves you. He's always loved you. He always will love you. And I just want to thank you, brother. Thank you so much.
All right. Thank you for having me on.